Donald Trump saying that Kamala Harris has bigger cognitive problems than Joe Biden.
Why would you even cover that? Why would you even cover that? Why would you even cover that?
I know that we should not be ashamed to use and defend words and concepts like nation and patriotism. The West is more than a physical place. By the word West, we do not simply define countries by specific geographical location, but as a civilization built over the centuries with the genius and sacrifices of many. The West is a system of values in which the person is central, men and women are equal and free, and therefore the systems are democratic, life is sacred, the state is secular, and based on the rule of law. I ask and wonder to myself and to you, are these values of which we should be ashamed of? But to the authoritarian fans, let me say very clearly that we will stand for our values. We will do that. Our freedom and our values and the pride we feel for them are the weapons our adversaries fear the most. So we can't give up the strength of our own identity, for that would be the best gift we can make to authoritarian regimes. So at the end of the day, patriotism is the best response to declinism.
Why would you even cover that?
The referees we used to have to determine what's a fact and what isn't a fact have kind of, been eviscerated to a certain degree. And people go, and then people self-select where they go for their news or for their information. And then you just get into a vicious cycle. So it's really, really hard, much harder to build consensus today than at any time in the 45, 50 years I've been involved in this. And there's a lot of discussion now about how you curb those entities in order to guarantee that you're going to have, some accountability on facts, et cetera. But look, if people go to only one source and the source they go to is sick and, has an agenda and they're putting out disinformation, our First Amendment stands as a major block to the ability to be able to just, hammer it out of existence.
Why would you even cover that?
In 85, newborn millennials had to follow a schedule of just a handful of vaccines. Today, a child following the recommended vaccine schedule will receive up to 70 shots by the time they turn 18, including 27 before he or she turns 2, and as many as 6 shots in a single visit. Are all these shots producing healthier kids? According to the data, no. Are we allowed to even ask? Also, no. Some parents who've asked too many questions about the recommended vaccine schedule can find themselves reported to Child Protection Services. Or they will get kicked out of their pediatrician's office for not being compliant. This is America, the land of the free. Parents are being held hostage. They did not sign up to co-parent with the government. We want a divorce.
Why would you even cover that?
Hammer it out of existence. So
I have an amazing story to tell you real quick about what President Trump's father, Fred Trump, did for myself, for my brother, for my sister, for my mother. 1974, my dad suffered a major heart attack. I went to the same school as Donald Trump, the Pew Forest School. 3 days after my father's burial, there was a knock on the door one school morning, 7 a.m. I answered the door. It's a distinguished gentleman. I was 10 years old. My father just died. The gentleman said, kid, call your mom. I called my mom from upstairs. She came down. The gentleman said to my mom, I am Fred Trump, Donald's father. And my mom says, yes, I know Donald went to the Kew Forest School. And Mr. Fred Trump said to my mom, yes, Mrs. Rem, very sorry about Joseph's death. And what you don't know is I'm still on the board of trustees at the Kew Forest School. And this morning, I let headmaster Mr. Philip Rogers know that from this day forward, myself, Fred Trump, out of my own pocket, is going to pay for your 3 children's tuition because I don't want the kids to have to go back into the public school system. And the tuition in 1974 was $2,500 per child, $7,500, which is about $80,000, $100,000 in today's money. And who would do that except the President Trump's father. The fruit doesn't fall far from the tree, and they give the Trump family grief. The Trump family is a wonderful family, the entire family, sorry. And who else? Can you picture Joseph Biden or Kamala Harris doing that? No. All they care about is buying another mansion. I'm going to tell you, the Trump family is wonderful. I love you, Donald. I wish I could shake your hand. It was my mother's last dying wish to shake your hand and to thank your father, Fred Trump, for what he did for us kids in 1974 in Forest Hills, New York. I love you, President.
All the things that I've done and said, and I don't know if it'll ever be okay to show my face around here. Sometimes I wonder if I disappear. Would you ever turn your head and look, see if I'm gone? 'Cause I fear there is nothing left to say to you that you wanna hear, that you wanna know. I think I should go. The things I've done are way too shameful. Oh, you're just an innocent, a helpless victim of a spider's web, and I'm an insect going after anything that I can get. So you better turn your head and run, and don't look back, 'cause I fear there is nothing left to say to you, that you wanna hear, that you wanna know. I think I should go. The things I've done are way too shameful. Oh, and I've done it so wrong, treated you bad, strung you along. Oh, shame on myself. I don't know how I got so tangled up.
And the people of Arizona. She also did that entire speech in heels, and I think you should respect that. She's tough, tough as nails. My feet hurt, and I'm wearing flats. No, we have to secure our border because people are just pouring in. I'm not talking about from Mexico. I'm talking about from California, where people are pouring in, bringing California with them. Don't AZ my... I just left California. Just stop, stop it already. But this is a beautiful, wonderful state. It's too hot, but I can deal with it. I will deal with the freedom of this state, and I'll deal with the heat. Whenever it gets over 110, I go, thank you. Keep the people from California from moving here. The hotter, the better. So as someone from California, we have lost our minds in California. I have little kids who go to school. I had to take them out of California because California is dangerous for public schools, for kids. You know, in the morning you drop off a girl, in the afternoon you pick up a boy, you know. 30% during COVID tyranny went with it and were gung-ho about the COVID tyranny and did what the government said. 30% went along with it because it was easier. But 30% said, F you. It's my body. I'm not doing it. My family. And it was people in this state. And I said, I'm going to go fight with these people in Arizona. I'm not leaving Arizona. I'm staying here and I'm going to fight.
Vote for Grandpa.